Hello. Thanks for tuning in to see the presentation on Common Tasks Done with CASL. My name's Jane Eslinger. I'm a senior technical training consultant at SAS in the education division. CASL is a language specification used by the SAS client and other clients to interact with the CAS server. CASL is comprised of actions, functions, and statements. Much like the SAS programming language, CASL is used to input and output data, perform variable assignments, and analyze data. The focus of my paper and this presentation is common tasks. Tasks that you're used to performing in other languages, I'll show you what they look like when done with CASL. I've broken those tasks into three broad categories of housekeeping, which I could have just as easily called table management, summarizing, and ordering. What I'm going to do is focus on one subsection or example for each of those broad categories. Within the housekeeping category, I walk through a looping example. For summarizing, I'll focus on the RU stats action. Ordering is a slippery topic in the CAS world, so I'll discuss a little bit of what you can and cannot do and show an example of group by. Before I get into any of the examples, I want to level set and make sure everyone understands what a CASL action statement looks like. This is the syntax you would use from a SAS programming environment like SAS Studio. An action is one long statement. It starts with the action set name if one is needed. Actions are grouped into action sets based on functionality. The same action name can be used in more than one action set. If the name of the action is not unique, then you must specify the action set it is in. Follow that with a period, then the name of the action. For example, a summary action is found in three different action sets. I want to use the one from the simple analytics action set, so I put simple.summary. After the name of the action are the parameters and the values and options associated with that parameter. Depending on the action you are using, the statement can get pretty long. ProcCAS does run group processing. That means it keeps the line of communication with the server open until it hits a quit statement or a step boundary. You can run as many actions as you need in one ProcCAS step. I said we would look at an example of looping, a do-over loop specifically. Base SAS programmers might find that interesting because do-over is not supported there. In my programs, I have found that I need to loop over tables a lot without necessarily knowing how many tables there are or what they're called. How do you figure out how many iterations you need? How do you reference the thing you need to iterate over? I have found the describe statement is a helpful tool for answering those questions. If I want to loop over all the tables in a specific CASLib, I would first need to know the tables that are in that CASLib. The table info action gives me the names of the tables. I funnel the names into a result table here called TI. Before I do any looping, I run the describe statement. In the log, I can see the result table contains a dictionary. The dictionary name happens to match the action name, table info. The log also lists the columns in the table info dictionary. The one that is important to me is called name. It holds the names of the tables in the CASLib. I now know that the result table I need to use to loop over is ti.tableinfo, and the name of the column that I care about is name. I now take that information and add it to my do-over statement. I still start with the table info action and create a results table. Again, the name of the results table is TI. In the do-over statement, I want to iterate over the entire results table, which has how many of our table's names it has in it. Remember, we found out from the describe statement that the name of the dictionary is table info. The reference to it is ti.tableinfo. My goal is to drop all the tables in my CAS user CAS line. Therefore, within the do loop, I use the drop table action. In the name parameter for the action, instead of hard coding a name, I reference the column from the table info table called name. I prefix it with the I iterator I specified in the do-over statement. Running this code, I dropped all the tables in my CAS user CAS lab so I can start fresh. But as you can imagine, you can put any other action inside of the do-over loop, whatever works for the task you are trying to accomplish. I put this example in the paper, so I'm going to show it to you here, though a word of caution. This code might drop more tables than you intended to. I learned that one the hard way. What I want to show you is just like other languages, you can have nested loops in CASL. From the table.caslibinfo action, I create a result table called C. The first loop iterates over all the CASLibs. You see here, do J over C.caslibinfo. Then you'll see the same table info action from the previous example, creating a result table named TI. The second loop iterates over all of the tables in each specific CASLib. The dangerous part is the drop table action within the nested loop. You might not actually want to do that because, depending on your user positions, you might drop tables from CASLibs that you really didn't want to drop. Hopefully, you see that the same kind of task I would do in base SAS. I'm looping over a set of elements like tables or variables. The takeaway is that you can use a result dictionary table like you would use an array dimension. The other takeaway is that the describe statement is very handy. Analysis is taking a large amount of data and condensing it into bite-sized pieces. Everyone has to perform some kind of summarization. CASL has several actions that summarize, and the paper covers three of them. In this presentation, I want to discuss the RUStats action because it lets me calculate percentiles. If you ask for percentiles from a CAS-enable procedure, all of the data is moved to the compute server and processed there, not on the CAS server. And we don't want that to happen. We want all the processing to be done on the CAS server. Enter RUStats. You might be wondering why you are seeing PROC SQL code when I'm talking about using the RUStats action. Well, the reason is that the RUStats action requires that you list all of the variables that you want to summarize. And well, none of us wants to type out a whole list of variables. I'm using good old PROC SQL to create a macro variable called numvars containing a list of the names of all the numeric variables in my CAS table. The myUserLib name points to a CASLib. Just because I'm using CAS to do my summarization doesn't mean that all of my code has to be CASL. Here is the RUStats statement that will calculate the percentiles for me. The table parameter picks the name of the table I'm interested in and the CASLib it sits in. I just mentioned the inputs parameter. Notice I am referencing the macro variable because my table has a lot of variables. If I only cared about one or two, I would go ahead and hard code them. Note that each of the column variable names has to be inside of quotes, which I did do with the quote function in the proc SQL step. Request packages sounds weird for a SAS programmer. That's just what it is. I need it because inside of it is the percentiles package. For its arguments, the percentiles package requires a list of quantiles or percentiles to compute. While I was at it, I went ahead and used the scales package to get the standard deviations. The action has other packages like centralized moments and skewness. The results are sent to a table named mydata_rustats in the CAS user CAS lab. Just so you believe me, here's a screenshot of the mydata_rustats table. From here, you can do anything you need with those values. That could include sending them through another action, a procedure, making a graph, or putting it in a report for your boss. Today, I do have to give you a little bit of bad news. CAS is a distributed environment, which means there's no concept of ordering. Because it is a distributed environment, the order of rows in a CAS table is not predictable. That's not a bad thing. CAS returns rows as the processing completes from each node, and that's what helps it run so quickly. Before you get mad at me, let me assure you that that doesn't mean ordering or grouping can't be done. CAS will group rows on the fly when necessary, like when using the group by action. The group by action creates a table with unique values of a variable or the unique combinations of multiple variables. In this example, I want to get a table with the unique values of color. In base SAS, I would use proc sort to do this, or maybe even a proc freak, which would order the values behind the scenes. Here, group by, we see the inputs with color, and I'm creating an output table, in this case named example 21. The fetch action is just a way for me to see the results in my results window. These are the results that are in the example 21 that the fetch action are showing me. When I ran this code, the results came back in alphabetical order. That won't always be the case. I talk about it in the paper, but I also want to mention it here. A lot of actions accept the sort by parameter. Sort by will give the printed results in a sorted order. In whatever programming language you are used to, there are some tasks that you do in almost every program. CASL is no different. You need to save tables, drop them, look at the contents of a CASLib, loop over information, summarize data, and order data. I've given you a quick look at what some of those tasks look like in CASL. As I said, the paper has a few more examples, so be sure to check it out. But thank you for tuning in.